This is Pat Cox. Welcome to round one of an Aether Revolt draft here on Channel Fireball. I think this is a keep because I can play a 2-drop and reasonably expect to play a 3-drop. This does point to why you should be dubious about putting Calprowler in your deck. I mean, you know, we had 1/6-drop, whatever, but we're nowhere near casting it, so we will keep, though. And don't really have. There are ways in the format. There's a. I don't know what it's called, but the green enchantment you put on a land that you can sacrifice to draw a card. And Renegade Map has ways to, on turn two, make this a 4/3, but we're not so lucky. I did have a pretty nice draft the other day where I had two of this guy, and also had the guy with Revolt that gives you green, green. And I, like, used a Bandar to give myself Revolt, and then, like, turn three played that guy, and... Oh, actually, no, I used a green implement on a Bandar, then played the mana guy into this on my turn three, then my turn four, I moved counters from the Bandar and played another one of these, and my opponent conceded that turn, so that's pretty nice. Didn't get that lucky this draft. Alright, so my opponent has a Durable Handicraft in black-green, which is kind of the +1/+1 counters color, so that's probably going to be pretty good. I guess we'll try and kill them before that gets online. A little awkward that my removal spell is Prey Upon. Now I can just natural Obsolesce. Oh, I cannot. Every other one in the format hits enchantments, but this one does not, so... I was going to say I could kill this, but I cannot kill it. If I draw a land and can Outland Boar, then I'm in pretty good shape. My Prey Upon will likely kill basically anything. Jeez. This Druid of the Cowl is really screwing me here, huh? Oh, come on, lands. Alright, right on time. And this Druid's going to be pretty good in their deck, probably, you know, especially this game, if they having an extra mana every turn when that extra mana equates to a +1 counter is pretty nice. Alright, Long Tusk Cub. Stupid. Luckily I can just Prey Upon it. Could have Ornamental Courage, but... not particularly inclined to try and play around that. It's not a heavily played card. Also, don't really have anything else to do with my mana, and I want to be able to attack, and screw it. Alright. Guy cannot block my guy, right? Power to Urilis. Now it is going to be sort of hard to leave to make this continually unblockable against a Durable Handicraft. It's like pretty hard to block in general because the creatures are relatively small, but if they all come in with a +1/+1 counter, I guess my hope is that they play an artifact this turn so I can use this natural obsolescence, which based on what I've seen so far is pretty likely to get sided out. Unfortunate. Of course, if there are missing land drops over there, this becomes a lot less exciting. It's like, Cub is pretty scary, but it's actually possible I should have just, like, hit the Druid of the Cowl there. Since it was making it so my Night Market Guard couldn't attack, and that could attack into Long Tusk Cub. Alright, well... giant crappy creature to the rescue. Like, would have preferred to land there, but this guy's still gonna be fine. So I guess they could just move one counter from Bandar, and that would make it so their druid can block my Outland Boar. It's annoying. How about draw a Monstrous Onslaught? I'll move two counters. Alright, well, the Monstrous Onslaught's not doing as much now. This pretty well sums up why Bandar is great and probably the best green common. Just like being able to. Oh man. Alright, can't do anything about that. Being able to move counters around like that is just very powerful. Like, just makes your 2 drop not dead late in the game. I could really use in this deck is Destructive Tampering, I think it's called. The card that says either destroys an artifact or says creatures without flying can't block this turn. That'd be pretty good. Now, I guess I can go all in on the Druid of the Cowl and move Bandar counters over there. Doesn't sound very good, but I guess, like, in red-green, there's not really a lot I can punish that with. I mean, most of the removal, like, all the removal cares about power, so. Alright, so Monstrous Onslaught would be a good draw right now. It would be the best draw. I have Killer Druid of the Cowl, and then everything can attack profitably. I mean, it depends on what they cast, but I guess if I actually draw that, I should probably figure out, like, there's some chance that it's just better to kill several smaller guys, and, like, then I could kill them. I don't know that that's going to be the case, but see if I draw it. I didn't draw it. Alright, so I can attack with my Cowl Prowler. But is that even good? That doesn't seem like that could be good. It's just like they triple block with these things, or just even Druid of the Cowl and something else, and then I still don't really have very profitable attacks. So I don't think I want to do that. I would really like this Natural Obsolescence to be any other spell. That'd be good. Like, what if this was just +3/+3? That'd be insane. Yeah, that's probably smart. Makes my Monstrous Onslaught significantly less good if I cannot kill their Druid of the Cowl. I guess I can just kill these three. At this point, it would have to be right to kill those three things, right? Like, if they didn't cast anything else, they would just be dead. Alright, well, it seems like they're trying to turn on Revolt. Presumably for, like, a Lifecraft Calvary or something. want a Monstrous Onslaught so bad. Just never have any good attacks. God, this is why Destructive Tampering is so good. Like, there's a decent number of board stalls in this format, and normally you can only sideboard Falter type effects. I mean, you can do whatever you want, but should, just because they're dead some amount of the time. But given that it's stapled onto another typical sideboard card, though I'm main decking the same type of card right now, like Artifact Destruction, it's just enough versatility that it is pretty good. But it has been probably like 3/4 of the time I just use it as the Falter effect. I guess I must have drawn a Revolt card, because it is pretty interesting to not use the Bandar the previous turn if they really wanted to turn on Revolt. Like, they can, this turns it on at will, but during your upkeep. There is a pretty decent shot that Onslaught is still just going to be lethal if and when I draw it, just because I get to kill multiple blockers and I have a pretty big board. I guess I can't kill multiple blockers if they leave up Durable Handicraft. Oh, called it. I had that stupid Lifecraft Calvary. Yep. Alright. I don't think I'm going to win this game. I think my out of Onslaught has just gotten too bad as the creatures got too big. And, you know, it's kind of what I said at the start of the game. Durable Handicraft might be a problem. Yeah, I would assume it's got to be right to move this. Yeah, like, puts me on a 3-turn clock. So I need to get pretty lucky at this point. Alright, so take 12. If I top deck Onslaught, I kill something. Well, first of all, this would have to be they don't have anything. But let's just say they don't have anything. Then I kill something. I can jump my 6-6. Take 9. Yeah, they're definitely dead. Now, if they have something, so they can block two things, then they're not dead. And this can become an 8-8. So the problem is, if I don't block here, then I'm dead next turn to this Foundry's Creature. If I do block here, and they don't have another guy, then Onslaught isn't out to kill them. I do have two Onslaughts, but they also have to not have another guy. So I would imagine it has to be right to just, like, double block here, which has to be with Cal Prowler, just because they have the ability to give +1/+1 counter to their guy. So I cannot block with 2/4 power or 2/4 toughness guys. So I guess I block. This kind of sucks. And they could just have like an actual pump spell and blow me out, but it would just be a 2/2. Like, I think they can only have like +3/+3. Alright. Well, I got a tidy conclusion. I guess maybe I was supposed to triple block there. Yeah, I was probably supposed to triple block there. I'll, like, block with the Sailback, too. Maximum punishments. It's like, do I even want to show them this? If I kill this, they could still attack with both these. Yeah, I'm still, like, literally dead next turn, I think. So, I don't think I should show them that. Alright. A little annoying. My deck that's trying to go big got it went bigger. All right, so this card just actually doesn't do anything. This card is probably like marginally playable against some hijack, but feel like Highspire Infusion is probably gonna do more. I think it's also probably better than Ornamental Courage, though Ornamental Courage is better against Natural State, I think it's called. Is that what it's called? The card that he used that cost one to green that dealt damage to my creature equaled their creature's power. Being able to like leave up a mana to save my creature from that seems pretty solid. I mean, pump spells do seem reasonably good in this matchup. I don't know if there's anything else I would want to cut. Want to play yet another one, but I don't really want to go too low on creatures. So I think this is probably fine. I do think I like the Crusher as a way to make my small guys not blank. All right, I would like to play first. Yikes. Don't actually know. Like, multiple prey pawns with my Outland Boar is pretty great. Obviously, pretty bad if I mean, if I it's not it's pretty likely I hit my third land by the time I need to, right? Like, and I do have two Night Market guards, so I guess it's a keep. It's pretty marginal. All right, well, one more and we're actually in great shape, so. But even if we miss for a turn, we're not in bad shape because we can cast something both turns. Well, it's really not a bad draw. Does go well with Night Market Guard. It's kind of silly that you like have to target something, but it would be fairly stupid if you misclicked and accidentally put counters on my guy. One of the dangers of Magic Online versus just normal. Well, this card is much better than my card. They might be trying to turn a revolt, but all they can really, unless they have that rare guy that I have, the only thing that can really revolt here is to draw a card, so. Or they can have a pump spell and spend their turn on that. Just don't really care about this Night Market card. Have a backup in my hand. Yeah, sure. This is interesting. I think it's probably better to just play Crusher here. Outland Boar is great, but this attacks for more immediately. Next turn, I could potentially Night Market Guard and Prey Upon. I don't necessarily. We'll see if I need to do that. If I don't, then I'm just going to Outland Boar. I have to have just drawn that Verdant Automaton since they didn't play another spell the turn they cast Bossman Defense. Alright, well. I don't really want this Long Tusk Cub to get going, so. I guess we're gonna fight. Let's see if they actually move into counters here. Man, it's not impossible. Like, they could. I don't know if making that a 2-3 does a lot, but. they have nothing else to do with their mana, they can make it a 3/4 this turn. I guess I want to leave the Bandar back to potentially trade with my Night Market card. I think I'd rather leave Outland Boar back as a blocker. Like, I could attack with Night Market Guard and trade, but it doesn't sound that exciting. Seems like having a guy that can keep popping in is probably better to leave around so I can attack my Outland Boar next turn. Yeah, if they're jumping, that's fine with me. Them having to chump on, like, whatever turn this is, 5 or 6 is, I'm pretty happy with. Alright, well, I admittedly didn't see that coming. Foolish. Not really sure how I avoid that, but. Well, there's a pretty good shot that they just have a tidy conclusion here. Given that, I clearly don't want to like be using my fight card. I probably like I could play another guy in crew, but I feel like if they tidy conclusion here and then I Chandra's Revolution. This, that's pretty nice. Though I guess, like, I do just have to crew this for them to do anything, so. Maybe I just attack? Yeah, I guess I'm, like, not exactly forced to crew here, so. Called it. So, I don't know that they should have actually used that there versus just putting a counter on, but I feel like their attack like a little bit broadcasts that. Like, if you leave it up but leave back the Bandar, then I don't really have a good attack at all. At this point, I'm just going to probably try to fight their automaton, assume they don't have anything. Prey upon. This doesn't really matter. I would assume it just aspirate to kill other stuff. They're not going to play a 6/6 next turn. I suppose I don't really need to do this. It's just a 2-power guy now. They're top decking. Could become a 3-power guy. Yeah, whatever. Don't actually know if this is right. If it's wrong, it's not super wrong, but yeah, I guess it had to have been right. Like, given the amount of expensive cards I have in my deck, it's like on five mana, I'm like basically no chance I'm double spelling if I have to cast that removal spell and something else in the same turn, so. I mean, that was a pretty sick draw. I guess I could have played around that. By having making a servo. I didn't even think about that card. I more thought about like they could have a guy that's big enough to block this. All right. Oh, hope I top deck a creature so I can crew this. Yep, that is not what I was looking for. Fortunately, Monstrous Onslaught deals the damage, so I can't Death Touch. So I have to jump block. So luckily in good shape, even though I played bad. Should have definitely made a servo there. Of course, now I'm just opening myself up to the second one, but you know, whatever. Not sure if there's really an easy way to make my deck not bad against that that edict. Just have a decent number of artifact creatures. I mean, I could side out Iron Tread Crusher. Don't really want to. I think we're probably just okay as is. Well, sand is pretty bad. I don't know why I keep drawing all my prey upons. Well, bad is a strong term, but as it currently stands, the prey upons are not good. They are good in my deck, so I think this is probably a keep, but it's an awkward keep. I guess, as have been all of my keeps so far, they've all needed some help. Well, a Thriving Grubs is a very good draw here. It's not not helping with the prey upons, but it's still a very good draw. Just being able to cast a 2-drop. Especially when my opponent's not casting a 2-drop is quite nice. Alright, Sailback is also a very good draw with these prey upons. I think I'm fine offering the trade because I'm reasonably scared of flyers with my deck. Also, just hanging back forever does not sound like a good strategy. No, not that they can cast it yet, but I guess I'll just play into their stupid edict. Snake. Well, that does make the Verdant Automaton that I've seen quite a lot better. Like, I don't like that card very much, but I think it's a pretty reasonable slash good inclusion if you have the snake. Well, we know they have Blossoming Defense, but I would be shocked if they used it like defensively here, no pun intended. Just I have mana open and it seems a like good way to throw away your snake. Like I could see just blocking and trading, that's good, right? But wow, really? People are crazy. They just play into other people's mana. Like, they might just have Fatal Push, too, but, you know, whatever. Not that big of a deal. I don't really care about my Thriving Gubs. I'm just honestly shocked. Like, I would just accept the trade there and be happy. Especially Blossoming Defense. Like, you know, you've seen I have Prey Upon. I don't think I've seen Monstrous Onslaught, but the Monstrous Onslaught, I forget if it targets or it's just like divide as you choose or whatever, though. Would still save a creature. Alright, so they get a 4/4. Pretty good. Alright. Well, I could fight right now, or I could just do a lot of fighting next turn, which is probably better. So I can play Sailback, and the next turn I can, like, fight two things with my Aether Herder and my Sailback. I guess chump here. See what they have. Yeah, Calvary is like moderately annoying. Like, I probably want to fight the flyer. And that's just a question of, do I want to also attack with my Sailback? I guess probably not. Probably just need to, like, pump the brakes a little bit and, like, trade my Sailback for one of these guys. Could also like wait and prey upon a bigger thing later. I don't know that I want to do that. So prey upon this, I'm gonna attack and then play Welder Automaton, and then I can like block both of these with my Night Market Guard. Might be okay. Like if they trade, I'm in pretty good shape, I think. Yeah, that's fine. I guess that could have been a reason not to fight last turn. Like, obviously, if I top deck a land and play my Calprowler, then it kills 4/4s, but not really trying to get too greedy here. Alright. Trades for both, I'm happy with that. I don't think they can have any kind of wrath effect. I guess they could have -2/-2 to everything. That would... I mean, it wouldn't be like a huge blowout, but it would be a reason not to play that spell. Alright, seems reasonably likely they're dead. Haven't done any math, but let's see. So if they block like this here, and then chump block this, that's 9 still. They have 0 cards in hand, so... Block 6, block 3, still 8, even without the Wilder Automaton's ability. I'll attack with all my creatures. I do not have any energy, so I'll not do that. All right, I will see you guys next round.